Hello and welcome to Berwick Mitsubishi. My name's Wayne. I'm going to give you a full video walk around of our 2013 Pajero GLXR. We'll start at the front. Car is presented in stunning metallic silver, very good condition throughout all the paintwork. You'll notice the fog lights in the front bar there. Xenon headlights, very good for driving at night, very bright. Across the front, you'll notice in the paintwork, very clean, only a couple of very minor stone chips which have already been touched up. And moving around to the driver's side, looking down the panels, there's no dents, no major scratches in any of the panels down this side. 17-inch alloy wheels from factory with very good tyres there. Factory fitted side steps, colour coded door handles, side mouldings. To be very critical, a couple of tiny little chips here, but again, already been touched up. Again, very good tyres here on the back of the car as well. Moving around to the back of the car, you'll see all the badges are intact. The car does have factory fitted reverse camera, which is here on the hard wheel cover at the back of the car. This particular Pajero hasn't actually been fitted with the tow bar, which means it hasn't had any heavy towing of any kind, obviously just being a family's seven-seater car. We'll go into the seven seats shortly when we open up the back there. Again, having a look down the passenger side of the car, the previous owners really looked after the car well. No major scratches in the panels. All the paintwork is very clean. Alloy wheels are all unmarked. And again, good tyres all round. Again, certainly very well cared for, 78,000 kilometres on the clock, and apart from a couple of very minor stone chips, paintwork on the car itself is very, very well presented. Moving under the bonnet of the Pajero now, very easy to find the latch rod at the tip of the diamond. You've got easy to find rod at the front there, hold the bonnet right up out of the way. Under here is Mitsubishi's very famous tried and true product, 3.2 litre common rail turbo diesel. Very impressive engine that's been around for a long time, producing 147 kilowatts of power and very impressive 441 newton metres of torque. The car is a very well designed tow vehicle and will also be able to get up and go in a case of maybe pulling out in front of someone or needing to overtake. Fuel efficiency on the car is excellent, running at an average of 9 litres per 100 kilometres. So given those stats, you should see yourself getting over 950 kilometres per tank, depending on obviously the way that you drive. And as you can see under the bonnet, all very clean and certainly well maintained there as well. Moving into the back of the Pajero now, it is a side swinging door with the handle just off the left side of the spare wheel. You'll note on the door here, it's also got a lock, which is fantastic. You push that forward and it stops the door from being able to close in the wind, so there's no chance of it pushing against you. Got a small amount of storage in behind this plastic compartment here, and it's also how we get into these little compartments for the hard wheel cover on the back of the spare wheel. In the back, you'll see a good amount of space here just behind the third row seats. Genuine seven seat option here in the Pajero. And fantastic configuration in the fact that you can fold them underneath the floor and have the total space in the back, unlike other seven seaters where you have to fold them up to the side or they only fold halfway down. Very simple configuration for that to happen. Simply remove the floor, one handle, drop that down, pull the one in the middle, folds completely flat underneath the floor. Put that back, and that's as simple as it is. Very, very easy configuration. Another good thing to note with the third row seating is you remove these two plastic covers and you can take that seating out. So if you don't need the seven seats, it opens up that additional storage under the floor as well. In the back, you'll note very clean, a couple of minor little scratches over on the left-hand plastics there, but other than that, still very well kept and clean in the back. Factory anchor point for the child seats, and you'll see there is provisions there for other ones if you do need the third seat across the back there as well. So sitting inside the Pajero now, I'll give you a full rundown of all the internal features the car has to offer. Starting on the right hand side, full electrics. You've got electric windows, front and rear, and also the window lock there to stop the kids in the back from playing with them. Door locks. You've got the front fog lights and also rear fog light button and the electric mirrors. Having a look at the mirrors, you can actually fold them in when you're at the shopping center. Stops people bumping them with trolleys or push bikes. And moving across to the steering wheel, full leather wrapped steering wheel. It is multi-function with your cruise control, all your stereo controls, and also factory fitted Bluetooth controls down the bottom here. Really nice dash layout behind the steering wheel there too. Silver metallic finish, white numbers, very easy to read. You've got your four-wheel drive control system lights in the middle, cruise control lights lit up, and handbrake and so forth right in the middle there. Sitting at just under 79,000 kilometres. The car has had an intermediate service done by us here at Berwick Mitsubishi, so not due for a service for another 10,000 kilometres. You've got headlight controls and indicators over here on the right-hand stalk, full wiper controls on the left-hand side, including the one for the rear door. Moving up to the rear vision mirror, as mentioned before about the reverse camera, you'll notice the left-hand side of the mirror there, very clear and colour display, and it's also got the automatic dimming function there in the mirror itself too. Moving down through the centre console, you've got a full information display panel there, showing outside temperature. There's a number of different information factors, elevation, barometer, the date, the time. You can also have it turned off to complete black as well. Fuel economy obviously isn't going to read right because it's sitting here idling. Shows your range to empty there as well. Moving down through the center, MP3 CD player. Very good sound quality in the Pajero. Mitsubishi don't cut corners there. Very, very clear. Having a look down here, you've got the auto climate control, fan speed on the right hand side, and you can also set the temperature here on the left and hit the automatic button, that'll run it itself. You've also got rear air conditioning controls, which we'll show you shortly, with a secondary control panel there as well. Additional storage down through here. You've got the factory rear diff lock in this particular Pajero. You've also got the power outlet in front of the gear stick there, just a plastic cover to keep dirt and grime out of there. Tiptronic automatic transmission. It is a 5-speed automatic. You can drive it in normal auto or flick it across to the Tiptronic side, change up or down the gears as simply as that. Great for towing or overtaking. Four-wheel drive system controls just over here next to that. Very simple, just a simple push down into four high, going through those controls there as you might need. Nice metallic finish to break up the colour of the centre console there. In the top of the lid here, small storage compartment at the top. You'll also note that this does have a slide function there for resting your elbow on, which is quite comfortable. And under there, you've got additional storage and another power outlet down in the center console there as well. Moving through the car, you'll notice it does have airbags all the way through. You've got one in the steering wheel, one in the passenger side dash. You've got side impact airbags in both of the front seats, and you've also got curtain airbags through to the front and second row passengers. Rear air conditioning controls, as mentioned before, on the back of the console. They can also be toggled on or off at the front of the car, and you'll also note that it does have air conditioning vents all the way through to the third row as well, so you do have children or even adults sitting there in the back, certainly going to be quite comfortable with the aircon reaching up there as well. So just to recap, 2013 Mitsubishi Pajero GLXR Auto in the turbo diesel. Very, very well presented car inside and out. Many features including the xenon headlights, alloys, side steps, and reverse camera from factory. If you do have any further questions, please don't hesitate to call us on 9907 0555.